Hey everyone, we're back in Ancient Rome for some more Shadow of Rome. This is going to be a later fight in the game to showcase like the different enemy types and the mixtures of enemies that you get. Can really be quite tricky sometimes, like especially when you get all three types mixed together. Because it's mainly the little guys that are the most annoying, like they're just really fucking irritating to fight. It's always best to come in with no weapons because, as I said, if you come in with no weapons, like, you can always just cheer, and you pretty much always get a weapon, like, when you cheer at the start. You can't block with a bow, for obvious reasons. But, I never really use blocking that much anyway, because blocking, like, severely damages whatever weapon you're using. Like, if you block an attack, like, that weapon will get pretty damaged just from blocking, like, one attack. So, I was trying to steal that guy's weapon there, but that didn't really work. And then I got stabbed, I think. That was not cool. Alright, let's try and get my, try and get the Magnus again. Out of that. Go! Like, they never move that quick. Like, I think they actually do have, like, separate, animations for, like, running to weapons, like, running to get weapons and health, and they do actually move them. Alright, let's try and get some little guy out of the way, because he's just... Like, these guys can, like, jump off walls and everything, and like, just, they're really just annoying, more than anything. Right, let's take care of him. Stop trying to stab me with that spear. You have no arms. Right, give me some cheese. Eat this cheese. And, going on what I was saying in the last video, I got the health stuff wrong. The health stuff's actually gauged to, difficulty. So, if you have, if you're playing on normal, you'll get the meat, cheese, and the bread. Like, it's kind of, like, meat is a hell of a lot of health, cheese is kind of medium, and bread's just kind of, like, you know, enough to stay alive, basically. But cheese is, like, a really good health item. Like, if you get, I think on hard, like, you get two cheeses instead of one meat and a cheese. And, on extreme, you, like, meat is never, ever there. So, well, that guy's stunned. Try and take him out with the mace. There you go. Brush his head. By hitting the D-pad, you put down the weapons that are in your hands. Try and show off a move with the spear, but it's been a while. Don't know if I'll be able to get the timing down. If you impale them with the spear, and then press X. Oh, no. Like, if you press X, he kind of, like, rips it out of them. On the bigger guys, like, it just looks like he's kind of disemboweling them, whereas on, like, the smaller enemies, like, you actually kind of, they stay impaled on the end of the spear, and then you, like, throw them over your head and, like, smash their head into the ground. It's a pretty awesome move. Alright, always good to have one of these going into the next bit. Now, as you can see here, there's like a sort of spike pitch. You can suplex the guys into there. Wow, they really look pretty shit, don't they? Yeah, you can suplex the guys into there. And that's obviously an instant kill, I think, coming back from that. Oh, I hate it when guys have got Morningstars. Morningstar enemies are easily some of the most dangerous in the game because they can stun-lock you and really mess up all of your attacks. Alright, there we go. The square move is a great move with this sword. Ow. Get my cheese. One of them's still got a left arm. Yep, that guy. And you really don't have to damage them much for them to try and steal your health. Like, you know, you can just kind of... Like, even if you cut off an arm, like, cutting off an arm's not doing a lot of damage to them in terms of health. But if you cut off an arm, they will go, like, straight away and they will go and try and get health. So... Pressing X when you're getting up throws sand at them, which is a really good move when you're surrounded like that. Alright, let's try and... oh, no, I didn't want to hit him. No, not him. God damn it. Try and lock onto that guy and hit him into the spikes. Oh, fine. Sacrifice yourself for your buddy. I can understand that. Now he's doing the wrong goddamn move. Alright. Okay, let's try that again. And he's just going to shoot me, isn't he? The bitch. Eat that. You're on your head. Can you stop attacking the wrong person? okay, fuck this. Where's my sword? Okay, where is my sword? Oh, there it is. It's kind of annoying that there's never really a way to tell, like, where your kind of power weapon is going to be thrown to you. Like, you just kind of have to get an angle where you can see, like, as much of the battleground as possible. And then just run to it, like, as fast as you can. Because, like, the enemies can run much faster than you when they're going for weapons. So, that's really kind of annoying. Alright, I didn't mean to kill that guy, but that was pretty cool anyway. Oh, got some cheese. That's a eat some cheese, and let's try and suplex this guy into the spikes. Okay. Oh, you can't move these, can you? Alright, well, let's see if this worked. No, that didn't get him in the spike. Oh well. No, let's carry on. But yeah, so this is a pretty tough fight. It's kind of making it very easy, but like, I've played this game a hell of a lot. In case you haven't noticed, going through all the screens, like, I've played this game a ton. Like, this was easily one of my most played games last generation. It just really was one of my favourite games that came out in the PS2 days. Alright, that guy's got no arms, so he's not really going to be that much of a problem. That being said, though, like, the bigger guys, like, the really huge enemies, like, they actually are pretty fucking, like, they're still pretty dangerous with no arms. Like, they've got, like, an overhead attack they do that kind of knocks you on the floor. Like, their kicks do tons of damage. So, you know, getting rid of their arms doesn't really make them, you know, any less dangerous. It just means they can't punch you. Okay, that guy, stop eating my cheese. Give me that. Overkill, I don't know what that is. Alright, let's try and take a hostage, and let's try and get the hostage killed by his friends. Because that's pretty funny. Right, hit me. There we go. Right, that killed him. Right, I should get another Magnus out of that. Yep, there we go. Alright, now let's let him not get stolen. I don't know if that guy had any brains, he'd try to steal that. Goddamn Morningstar enemies. Yeah, block that. That takes care of him. Get rid of that weapon arms. Well, it's kind of pick and choose, like, which arms you want to cut off, depending on the strategy. On the higher modes, like, you definitely want to cut off their weapon arm first. Like, if they have no weapon arm, like, they're kind of screwed, you know, for obvious reasons. But, that being said, like, on Extreme, it's been a very long time since I played on Extreme. I don't know if I'll do any of these videos on Extreme, because, like, the damage you receive is just absolutely insane on that difficulty. It really is crazy how much damage the enemies do to you. Alright, that's stunned. The Morningstar's a great weapon for stunning people. Just chuck him into the wall. Ah, I'm trying to stamp on him. Oh, got some more cheese. I can't remember the exact health that you get on the modes. I think, like, as I said, like, you get less, you definitely don't get any meat past normal, because meat gives you just tons of health back. But I think they kind of gauge that with giving you, like, more of the lesser healing items. Like, on Extreme, like, you get shitloads of bread, and it's only in, like, the very early fights that you get cheese, because obviously that gives you a lot more health. Isn't that little guy not dead yet? Yeah, he's dead. Alright, so we just got to finish these guys off. I didn't actually mean to do that, but yeah, we can suplex him. Alright, that killed him. Alright, let's try and, I want to try and kill this guy with a thrown weapon, because... Yeah, there we go. Thrown him. Oh, and he's... But yeah, when you do that, you can actually go and, like, press circle, and you can get the weapon out of them when they're impaled with it, which is pretty cool. It's a really, pretty neat-looking effect. And that's going to do it. Oh, I got silver again. That wasn't too bad. How close was I? Oh, only four and a bit. Three and a bit thousand off getting gold. So I'm probably going to do a chariot mission next. They're not that much fun in comparison to, like, the regular gladiatorial arena battles, but they're pretty well done. Like, they're a well done aspect of the game. So chariot one next, and I hope this was fun. See you guys next time.